Hello and welcome! In my last video on the question of whether or not Ainz is evil, the answer was a clear yes, because by today's moral standpoint, he committed many atrocities. And today we are going to take a look at the new world equivalent of judging Ainz Ooal from our own moral standpoint. We will take a look at Platinum Dragonlord's noble and just quest to end the taint of Yggdrasil. And I always found it bizarre that he presents himself and is presented as a force of good, as some sort of guardian who protects the new world from the evil Yggdrasilian taint. Because I personally venture to guess that he couldn't care less about the new world and is all about saving his own scaly and hopefully spell-receptive hide. Throughout the centuries, Platinum Dragonlord had the chance to take charge of a country, and not like the Arkland Council State, which appears to be neutral and defensive, like Switzerland but with dragons. I am talking about a true dragon kingdom that fights for the good of its people and tries to liberate and protect the persecuted and oppressed. From my perspective, Platinum Dragonlord had all the chances to help healing this war-torn, illness-ridden, starved world. And yet he did nothing. He could easily have established a state designed after his own moral and righteous thoughts, where he, thanks to his power, can ensure that all are protected and safe, that crime is low, and the food supply is ample. And he didn't do it. Nor did one of his fellow dragon lords. After all, the draconic kingdom is abandoned and is currently in the process of becoming a rich buffet for the Beastman nation. We also don't know about any state ruled by a true dragon lord which concerns himself with the solemn task of being a force of good. Again, for someone like Platinum Dragonlord, it would have been easy to reign as king for centuries, if not even millennia. He could be a stable anchor. But he didn't. He had the strength, but he didn't act upon it. And while the theocracy's humanocentric approach to peace is hardly appealing for a dragon lord or any other species besides humanity, at least they do something, at least they actively try to solve a problem and bring a form of lasting peace. So there's a thesis, but there's no apparent antithesis from Platinum Dragonlord's side, except to purge Yggdrasilian influence because it's evil. But this purge wouldn't solve any of the new world's problems. And also Platinum knows that there are good humans out there, that even among the players, good people existed, and yet he does not act upon this information or try to unite them in any form, except when outside forces, such as the evil spirits, likely Yggdrasil players, are forcing Platinum to get active. If he had kept the 13 heroes alive, if he had protected the demi-human parts of them from persecution, or if he joined cause with any human nation, he would have had a full century to create his own form of justice and good, which he then could present to or use against Yggdrasil players. But again, he didn't. Instead, he became an anachronism, a relic of an era long past, clinging on to a time where the Dragon Lords had the power necessary to stay passive and yet still be the undisputed rulers of the new world. And these times are over. And even if he didn't want it to reign, if Platinum Dragon Lord truly was a force of good, then he could have easily prevented wars among the realms of men, as well amongst any other race. But again, he didn't. Even worse, he kept the relics of the 8 kings of Avarice out of the hands of the normal humanoids, demi-humans and heteromorphs who are in desperate need of them. The whole time, they could have prevented hunger, war, sickness. He did nothing. Behind the veil of benevolence rests nothing more than arrogance and a sense of lazy supremacy. The just dragon is seemingly blind to all of the suffering he could have prevented. In contrast to this, Ainz actually wants to, and currently is in the process of, building a utopia, where all species could live in prosperity, where peace between the citizens is maintained by unbiased courts, and where it is upheld by a gruesome, horrifying, evil-looking, but ultimately neutral police force, where food, water and living space is readily available, and where all can live a good life, and contribute to the advancement of society on their own way, and in return get paid and praised accordingly. What Ainz Ooal currently builds is closer to the nice future of Star Trek than to the average dark fantasy overlord and his evil realm. Compare this outcome to Platinum Dragonlord, who sits in someone else's home, plays with their stuff, and silently judges people. I mean, this Dragonlord is more akin to a cat than a force for good. Under his watch, countless wars were fought, countless catastrophes had happened, and countless people died of sickness, all while Platinum watched it unfold, while he could just have animated his armor and prevented these wars, where he could just hand out some items from Yggdrasil for farming, healing and other stuff, you know, like he did when aiding the 13 heroes against the evil spirits. And to me it is no coincidence that Platinum Dragonlord is introduced to us sleeping, until Rigrit disturbed his sleep. He is only concerned for the safety of the world, when his own scaly hide, his own kind is threatened. All the death and misery that happened around him on a day-to-day basis seems neglectable to him. And if anything, Ainz Ooal could rather judge him than the other way around. And while the way to his utopia is littered with the bodies of the innocent and the guilty alike, it's at least a means to an end. Then, not if, when Ainz Ooal conquered the world, it will be at peace. A peace not only for the most powerful race, but for all species alike. In contrast to this, if Platinum Dragonlord wins, the Yggdrasilian taint is banished, and the Dragonlords will slowly reclaim their former glory. The good and just will have won. Meanwhile, countless millions of New World denizens will die every day, and the Dragonlords, once again, couldn't care less. But hey, as long as Platinum Dragonlord hands out a few items here and there, it is totally fine that he sits on a stockpile of miracle cures that he refuses to share with anyone but his friends. In a sense, Platinum is the Remedios of his kind. Wait, I take this back. He's worse. At least Remedios Custodio tries her hardest to ensure that all of her queen's subjects are safe and secure. And while she's a stupid, annoying, dismissive, unnerving, incompetent, holier-than-thou boss, at least she does something. At least she fights for what she believes is right, even when her own skin is quite literally at stake. While Platinum stays passive, unmoved by the daily horrors of the new world. So in conclusion, Platinum Dragonlord masquerades her self-preservation as being good and protecting the world, while Ainz Ooal and his guild wages one brutal war of conquest after another. But his methods will lead to a lasting peace. And in contrast to Platinum, Ainz, the undead, emotionally inhibited overlord, truly cares about his citizens and would go through a considerable amount of trouble to safeguard his sorcerer kingdom. And if you would ask the denizens of the new world and confront them with two options, a brutal but swift war and lasting peace thereafter, or no war except the daily raids of demihumans, being hunted down by mercenaries, or simply starving to death as part of your everyday life, or rather your everyday survival, well, I believe that most people would choose the sorcerer kingdom over the old ways, where uncaring dragonlords reign supreme. And lastly, Platinum Dragonlord's judgment is biased to no end. Let me give you an example. The Empire of Baharut purposely waged an economic war in order to create a countrywide famine in the Rhaestyle kingdom. The starvation, the sickness, the collapse of any public order, the ensuing violence, and the upcoming civil war would have ultimately ended in way more than just 200,000 deaths. But again, Platinum didn't care for the kingdom. Even though Blue Roses, the former team of his old friend, fights tooth and nail to protect it. In a new world where war and death are nothing unusual, Ainz did nothing more than every other nation, human or otherwise, did in the past and present. And yet Platinum grew concerned with the appearance of Yggdrasilian power. And undoubtedly he views the Sorcerer Kingdom as a force of evil, even though his methods aren't out of the ordinary, and even though it has done more good for its citizens than Platinum will ever be able to. So all in all, Naya's judgment seems spot on. Only those who have power and use this power to protect the weak, until they became strong and can defend themselves, are just. Platinum could have easily been the shield of humanity or any other race or combination of races, guiding their fate and implement a government system and a form of good and justice to his own liking. And yet, he did nothing. So in a world where might makes right, Platinum's moral compass and his definition of good and evil doesn't hold up, based on his action or rather his inaction. But that's just my opinion on the Dragon Lord. What's yours? Be sure to let me know in the comments whether or not Platinum is in any position to judge Ainz Ooal and Nazarick. And with that said, a few words to my last video on this topic. All of these individual videos I made are meant to be seen as part of a greater series. A series in which I take on different viewpoints and try to find a, or rather multiple answers to the question of whether or not Ainz Ooal is evil or not, depending on the perspective chosen. So please don't take anything I said in any of these videos, including this one, as the gospel truth, but rather as another perspective, as a different lens through which I view and analyze Ainz and his actions. And with that said, thank you for watching, have a nice day, over and out.